right now we are en route to Tiree via quite a few stops. So I'm going to stop off at Glasgow Airport to pick up a special guest. And then after we pick him up from the airport, we're going to pick him up at 12 o'clock, so midnight, at Glasgow Airport. And then after that, we are going to head off to Oban to catch the ferry for Tiree tomorrow morning. I just left Brighton yesterday evening. Nothing really much happened yesterday, so this is officially day one of the trip. And at the moment, I am just outside of Newcastle. Probably not going to get much sleep tonight, but hopefully I'll get a little bit of rest, because tomorrow actually I think is a pretty good forecast on the island, so we could hopefully score some quite fun conditions. I'm going to stop talking now. I'll probably give you guys an update once I'm at the airport. See you in a bit. At the airport, and I tell you what, it's freezing over here. It feels like it's just dropped like 10 degrees coming from Edinburgh to Glasgow, but yeah, definitely not used to this cold. Fucking soft southerner. There he is.
Please.
I think we're gonna have to take it off, eh?
Was pretty good overall. Except for the last gate.
All packed and ready.
Yeah, ready to go.
we actually don't have too much time. Well, we have time, but we gotta get moving.
Let's go. We don't wanna miss the ferry.
So I think we're going to get there at 5, and then the ferry is at 6, so not too much time to waste.
Waking up?
Yeah, finally. To a beautiful sunny morning, heading to Tiree, finally.
It's a windsurfer.
Oh yeah.
Two, three, four.
I think those are the kids.
But there's waves.
That's your first English breakfast. Scottish breakfast.
Scottish breakfast was pretty nice to have it.
Finished it.
It was bad, yeah. Didn't like it.
Back in the gaff.
Welcome home.
Yeah. Or destroyer.
It's looking pretty bad.
Leaks turned up.
So you sail mostly downwind or try to stay up in the rough?
Pretty much. Doesn't matter.
Hope keep that.
Alright, here we go.
Take one.
Uh oh.
Wait a second. I have to make myself a bit more.
Not beautiful enough.
No.
So, little update from Tiree. It's day three of the trip. Drove up on day one. Wednesday arrived at the airport, and then we drove kind of through the night to the ferry on Wednesday morning, and we were pretty freaking tired. I think I did 11 hours driving in total, so it's pretty heavy. And then we arrived, on Wednesday morning to the island, and had a bit of a sleep, and then we actually got a pretty good evening session on Wednesday evening, last night. So it's good to finally get into some nice waves again after a while. Yeah, today we are at Balavillin, which is like on the north shore of Tiree. And it's not looking really epic, but I think it could be quite fun in a bit. Scotty's just gone out on 5-0. Who's that?
How you doing?
How you doing?
See you.
What are you taking out?
5.
Nice. I looked at the fridge.
Checked it off a wee bit as well.
Yeah, with the push and tide. Yeah. Did you check the maze or? Yeah, this year a bit different. Normally I'm with my dad in Tiree, but this year I've got a new caddy with me. New younger, fresher, so hopefully he can carry all my equipment. this is, if you don't know, Miguel. You did a few stops on the world tour this year.
Yeah, did three of them.
Yeah.
We've been on trips together before.
Yeah, we were in Cape Town, was probably the last trip, right?
Yeah, and then Gran Canaria.
Well, Poser, we went to Poser together, so. It's always good to sail with him. He's doing pretty well. And hopefully he can knock out Phil Horrocks for me, basically. That's what I'm hoping for. And then I can win. Oh, it'd be pretty sick to have a final together though.
Yeah.
If we could. It would suck to be in the first heat together, but we'll see how the draw goes. We've got today and then tomorrow, which is Friday,
which is looking pretty good.
Tomorrow's looking sick. And then on Saturday is the official first day of the comp, so we got a few days of practice. We'll see how much filming we can get done. It's probably going to be a lot of rushing around, but we will see. Keen bean. Reefs out there. Right, this is day 4 of the trip. We just woke up. It's really strong, windy today. We went to go check Crossopole, where there was about 40 people out, super busy, and kind of slightly cross off, but really windy and like really small waves, so we didn't really fancy going out there. It just looked like we'd get a bit frustrated, so we actually gone for a little explore around the island, and we're here at I think it's called Balafetrish, and We thought we'd actually sell the beach break here, but we noticed a few little reefs out there. And then this one just over here was looking pretty good, so we actually decided to go out. 3740. We scored, no?
Yeah, well, it was pretty fun.
It was kind of port tack jump in, and there was a nice sort of bowly wave, which at one bit was pretty shallow, but yeah, we managed to avoid any injuries to ourselves or the kit and had a pretty good one. So we're gonna go get something to eat, and then hopefully the wind's gonna swing around a bit. We're hopefully gonna get another session at Balafuel, which should be starboard tack cross off. So far so good. So, just wrapping up this vid from the first few days of Tiree, we've actually scored some port tack jumping, starboard tack riding, and a little bit of jumping actually, and had probably one of the best days ever in Balafuel the other day. We were on 3-4s, 3-7s, down the line, starboard tack. I was absolutely loving it. But yeah, we're pretty tired after all of that, but I think we're going to have a few rest days on the island actually. But yeah, thanks for watching. If you got this far, apologies for the lack of action. We don't actually have like a designated filmer here, so it's just little bits and pieces. But anyway, I think we're gonna have plenty of wind coming up towards the end of the week for the classic, and hopefully plenty of action. So yeah, sick. Hopefully see you soon.